something happen. Oh, I see. That's not too good, is it? Well, I'm sorry to hear that. That must be upsetting and frustrating. Do you want to talk about it? Would you like solutions? Possible solutions? Or just some good old fashioned comforting? Okay. Alright. Well, I can do that. Would you enjoy it if I gently, slowly, tickled and traced on your arms? All right, sweetheart. So, first things first. I think it's really important and healthy to recognize, to name, verbalize negative emotion. While there's great value in being positive, seeing the bright side, trying to see the good in others, we don't want to engage in toxic positivity. Sometimes things bad or frustrating, upsetting, and that's part of life. And the reason why it's part of life is because these negative feelings are a response that we create in our brains when what we value, what we find important, is undermined or threatened. So, the feeling of being angry, feeling betrayed, feeling frustrated, is a response to something you love or you value being taken for granted, seen as less valuable. And so, even though it feels horrible, that's fine. It's fine for you to feel horrible because that's what's important to you. But you're not going to wallow in that feeling of feeling horrible. We're going to use it as an opportunity to say, okay, well, what is it that I value so much? And that's how. These negative feelings, they're not wrong. We may maybe you don't want to sit in them, wallow in them forever, but we can use the experience to say, okay, I need to regroup, check in with myself, and see why I feel so strongly. And sometimes it's just a really important step in the emotional process. In fact, not sometimes, it is. And it allows you to remember yourself. It allows you to remember what you value, what you hold dear. And even though it still is frustrating or upsetting, the situation isn't going to go away just because you know why it hurt you so much. But it is a sort of comfort to know that this negative, unpleasant, hurtful emotion is a response to something that you value being acknowledged by your mind. You're not forgetting yourself. And sometimes we do forget ourselves in situations with other people. Sometimes it can be overwhelming. Social settings. And so it's sometimes a rare opportunity to step back and say, who am I? What is important to me? What are my most treasured values? Tiny consolation in this case. But a consolation nonetheless, wouldn't you say? Now, I know you didn't ask for solutions, just a bit of comfort. But I do have a tiny bit of advice, if that's okay. I want you to remember your identity is not the helper. You can be the helper, and you're very good at it, and you enjoy it, but that's not all of who you are. That's not the label. It's just one aspect. Avoid the routine of saying yes. Avoid sacrificing yourself. Because the helper can get you want to avoid that, because it's very hard to bounce back as someone who sees themselves as the helper. You have to remember, people around you have to remember, that you also need help at times. You have needs too. Sometimes it's someone else's turn to fulfill your own needs. And sometimes the most pressing need of all is the need to not be needed. It's the need. people that you're helping or people that you care about, people you love. And you would hope that these people that you care about and you love you too, right? And what is it that you want people to love about you? Is it that you're the helper? What is it that you want people to love about you? Your family, your good friends. You want them to love you. Not what you can do for them, not what you always do for them, but who you are. And if you burn out, you can't be who you are. Type of people that you want in your life, that you might worry about in this sort of instance, because you still want to help, you want to be there for them, as long as they are valuing you for you, not what you can give. As long as there's reciprocation, I think it's healthy. But if it's not, if there isn't, then we maybe need to reevaluate. So, in addition to not burning out, I would also advise, suggest that in addition to not identifying yourself as the helper, find your identity again in all the things that joy and excitement, the things for which you feel passion. So again, reevaluate what brings you joy, what kinds of activities have you maybe put away for a little bit too long, what's exciting about the routine you have now that you might be able to increase on, make you more yourself. Think about what you'd most like to learn next. Develop yourself into full, rich, complex you. Spend time on you. Expand yourself. Grow yourself into the type of person you want to spend time with. You know, I always say, interesting people are interested people. So get interested again. Put time and effort into what brings you joy, excitement, what you want to learn. It's going to make you the youest you. A full, complex, interesting you. be the helper that doesn't have to go away at all. But let it be a part of you, not your identity. Those that really care about more than you can give. And anyone who does want more than you can give, they probably don't deserve anything, to be fair. So take that to heart. You can be the helper. But mostly, some sense of calm, sense of peace in your heart. It's not a situation that can be easily fixed. These things don't solve themselves on their own, and even when we put our efforts towards them, it doesn't change in one or two conversations. Remember, in the future, when these negative emotions surface, that it's a way to remember who you are, what you value, and what's important, and that stability of self. Sometimes it's the only thing that can get us through a difficult situation that can't be easily changed. So I hope you feel a little bit better. I'm always here to have a listen, to offer a little bit of peace.